Is your PC not good enough to run this game? Do you own a console? Well, let me explain what you're missing out on. Remember when you were little and wanted to break your friend's Lego city he built, but then eventually get grounded for being a dick? Well, Teardown allows you to smash. Shotgun equals door creation device. Blow up.
Don't tip over, you fat fuck! You motherfucker.
And more to your heart's content in order to complete the mission at hand.
Why did I do this earlier? Go! You son of a bitch!
There will be more videos coming out later and put in a dedicated playlist. It's in the description below, or smash this.
Dude, I didn't make a hole that big. What are you talking about? All I did was knock the door down. See?
Oh, because of that, now you want to add security to make it even harder.
Dude, you even locked the gate? Come on, man. I just want to break your place down.
Forget rock, paper, scissors. How about sledge, tree, fence?
The mission is there's three key cards I need to steal within 1 minute, denoted by these three dots here, here, and here.
Now it's time to start blowing stuff up.
Dude, that barely made a dent.
Now that's a hole I'm satisfied with.
Teardown does a wonderful job easing you into its complexity, and some could even say it's rather easy. That is true if you only do the bare minimum. But as you will soon see, the real challenge comes from the optional objectives, and also screwing up.
Oh, shoot.
Nope.
Thankfully, he found a vehicle in order to finish this on his first attempt.
Alright, that was way too easy. First try? Come on, bring it on, game. You bought a yacht. It's too large, and there's no space. Well, this is definitely how you make your deck a little bigger.
You're dead. And stop.
The house is still standing? Alright, that was actually very cathartic and pretty dope, but now it's time to get serious and drown a safe.
That guy wants me to get rid of any evidence that home I just destroyed even existed. Never mind. Let's instead try to put you on top of this car. I think that's how physics work.
We got this, in the ocean we go!
Oh, there's another one I need to get? Oh, please fall into the truck. Hell yeah. Into the water we... Since there's no timer, I can casually get to the exit. That's a good enough parking job. Let's finish the mission. Dude, still first try. You gotta make it harder for me. Come on. Shotgun. So not good against brick, but wood? Good. What does plus one damage even do?
You happy?
Reasonably.
Hell yeah, man. Shotguns are the best. Let's upgrade as much as I can right now.
In this mission, I need to steal two cars donated by the yellow dots, which can be completed first try, no problem, designed for babies.
Wait, each car has an alarm?
Wait, can I bring it just closer to where I need to take it?
But if you want the true experience of the game, you have to do all of the objectives.
Wait, how do I get out of here? Oh yeah, I forgot. Shotgun equals door. So now this car is immediately where I need to go, which is... Oh, this is a metal locked door?
Oh, yeah!
Oh, it's a metal door. You know what that means?
Nope.
I absolutely love games with physics. There's so few that actually get it right and make it fun. And this one definitely does. Thank God this car is nailed to this truck bed. Otherwise, it would fall off very easily.
Dude, I can complete the main mission in 15 seconds.
These side objectives aren't required for the story, but they are required for fun.
All right, let's get these vehicles in position so I can quickly move between objectives. And we're off.
Dude, I don't even know whose cars I'm stealing. This is probably gonna turn out to bite me in the ass, but a job's a job.
Can I make this jump first try, unlike last time?
Go, you fucking jump. Jump, you asshole, jump.
The harder this game gets, I don't know how I'm gonna convey when I fail dozens of times.
Dude, this Gordon guy is really turning me into an asshole for stealing the vehicle registration documents as well. I mean, once I'm done using this truck, I'm just gonna toss in the ocean. I'm just gonna use and abuse everything in this game. Learned my lesson here on how to move a car quicker back up into it instead of turning around like a dumbass.
If I screw this up, I know what I need to do.
Alright, okay, this was nowhere near as hard as I thought it was gonna be. E-Z-P-Z. The next mission is finally what I was asking for. A challenge.
You don't know me, but I've had a series of break-ins. I lost two classic cars. You know who did it?
I'm the last person I would have suspected.
And I gotta return the favor and dump three of his cars. So drive three of his cars into the water. But six are required for the true ending and a sick achievement. He's so rich he has a goddamn elevator in his house. Oh yeah, I guess I probably forgot to mention, but you find throughout the level valuable items that give you money, so you can spend that on upgrades. Of course, that's out of water. Let's take this sports car and let's do some vandalism first and give it some beachfront property views.
Ooh, what does this button do?
Can this one also go in the pool? Wait, this thing? Eh? Oh, you know what? That's actually good. That's actually really good.
Careful, SpongeBob! Careful, SpongeBob! Careful, SpongeBob!
What? How was it? Oh, okay, rip that. Nope. Nope. And carefully. No, that was not carefully. Alright, the first one was easy, dude. I just gotta set up a couple more cars so I can quickly travel. Did I mention that driving in a physics-based video game is tough? This is so slow. I'm so goddamn slow. I guess I'll go grab this truck and use it for some car hopping between other cars. As I do that, that's actually, yeah. That's actually way so much better. Yeah, that's so much better. Oh, just one vehicle, dude. Just one. How do you get all six of them, dude? All right, time to do some major changes. One, I do not want to make any sharp turns or flip over. All right, I want a straight line from here to the second car with this. Okay, yeah, I need an easy access to that car. What am I doing? Why am I bringing it all the way over here? All right, now I got this. I was still not in the car, but can this car stop the other car?
Myth confirmed.
You son of a f***ers. It's this one vehicle that's really screwing my pooch right here. So I can fit both of them in there. Good to know. Oh, the slow walk, dude. The slow freaking walk, brother. It's this shit. No! No, I got him! I got him! Go, you son of a bitch! You're gonna roll off, dude. You didn't fucking roll off, you son of a bitch! Final car, I can't go up north because the ocean's way too far. I gotta backtrack. It's gotta be in the pool. Okay. Oh my god. Okay. This is getting, try hard. How is that not in the... Alright, it's clean enough. Let's do this. This car heist kind of reminds me of one from a certain favorite co-op game, Payday. So I'm gonna use the music for a little nostalgic flair. Dude, these few seconds feel like it's taken forever. 12 seconds. You're made in the water, yes! Come on, 10 seconds. It don't take 10 seconds to walk here. They're like, oh my god, dude, that is a crazy mission. I have now unlocked wood. Insert penis joke. Also, I got pipes to blow.
Let's do a nice fast and simple one before we go back to one that's gonna make me split my hairs again.
All right, well, that's 2 out of 5 right next to the exit now. That's really good. I don't think I can get this out of here, so I'm just gonna park it here. This isn't the brightest idea, but I think I got this. You are correct, past me. It wasn't the brightest idea.
I'm retarded.
But hey, at least I got a smooth transition from boat to land to shotgun.
How many shells do you have in that gun?
I got 57 more goddamn rounds in this 4-round magazine.
I suck at driving in real life with trailers. No particular reason I mention that. Oh, you sack of Okay, so now this is the third GPS next to the exit. Now I need to find a boat so that I can get here from my other objective in the house.
Recently, I was diagnosed with erectile dysfunction.
All right, I can solve this. Attach another one to the flaccid plank to prop it up. Then do this, and you get a basic ramp.
Yes, science!
And we are a go.
All right, welcome to another easy teardown mission. All right, first he's got to get in this car. Make sure he doesn't go too fast. He's got to steer, go around a bend. Tokyo drift his way. Oh, doesn't even hit a goddamn... never mind, he hits that. He needs to go up his ramp that's now finally fully erect. Grab this thing. Oh, wait, where's the exit? There's the exit. Get to the boat. Now he hops out of it, lands in the water, barely even gets wet, struggles just for a tad bit to grab that GPS. Then he realizes he gets the truck one first, then he needs to go big boy boat, get that GPS, and now it's home sail, 20 seconds left. He ain't even sweating, this is easy, bro. He's gonna regret saying that in the next level.
Easy, dude. When you can put most of your objectives next to the exit, even a baby could do that. Probably should have worked on figuring out how to do these safes properly. I need to get these two safes into the dump truck and to the exit in under 40 seconds. No! Oh, no, you tipped over, you fat sack of shit.
We go someplace to dance. I know that there's a chance you won't be leaving.
Nope.
How hard is it to go up a wooden ramp?
Then afterwards we drop into a quiet little place and have a drink or two.
Don't you fall out, you fat sack of shit.
Come on, dude. You're so fucking goddamn slow, dude.
By saying something stupid like,
don't tip over, you fat fuck. You motherfucker.
I can see in your eyes that you despise the same old lies you heard the night before. And though it's just lying to you, for me it's true and never seems so right before. I practice every day to find some clever lines to say to me.
Don't tip over, don't tip over. Holy!
Oh my god.
That is a nutty freaking mission.
If you have the perfect plan, you don't need to practice.